afternoon. In keeping with tradition, will you all please rise and join us in the singing of God Save the Queen? Also, to save yourself the embarrassment of blubbering a bunch of cold swallop, you will find the lyrics on the back of your programs. Thank you.
Thank you. member of our band!
My friends, I thank you all from my heart for your kindly wishes. Would that I could repay them as they deserve.
What do you mean?
Today, I am out of my intentions. And today, I leave you forever.
But this is quite unaccountable. Why, a keener hand at scuttling a coonhogger or cutting out a white star never shipped a handspike.
Yes, I have done my best for you. And why? It was my duty under my indentures. And I am a slave of duty. As a child, I was regularly apprenticed to your band, and it was through an error. No matter, the mistake was ours, not yours, and I was in honor bound by it.
An error? What error?
I may not tell you, for it would reflect upon my well-loved roof.
Nay, dear master, my mind has long been gnawed by the cankering tooth of mystery. Better get it out at once.
Unspeakable, but collectively, I look upon you with a disgust that amounts to absolute detestation. Pity me, my beloved friends, for such is my sense of duty that once out of my indentures, I shall feel myself bound to devote myself, heart and soul, to your extermination.
Poor lad! Poor lad!
Well, Frederick, if you conscientiously feel that it is your duty to destroy us, we cannot blame you for acting on that conviction. Always act in accordance with the dictates of your conscience, my boy, and chance the consequences.
Besides, we
can offer you but little temptation to remain with us. We don't seem to make piracy pay. I don't know why, but we don't.
I know why, but alas, I mustn't tell you. It wouldn't be right.
But why not, my boy? Why, it's only 11:30, and you're one of us until the clock strikes 12.
True, and until then you're bound to protect our interests.
Yes.
Well, then it is my duty as a pirate to inform you that you are too tender-hearted. For instance, you make a point of never attacking a weaker party than yourselves, and when you attack a stronger party, you invariably get thrashed.
Well, there is some truth in that.
Then again, you do make a point of never molesting an orphan.
Of course, we are orphans ourselves, and know what it is!
Yes, but it has gotten about, and what is the consequence? Everyone we capture says he's an orphan. The last three ships we took proved to be manned entirely by orphans, so we had to let them go. One would think that Great Britain's mercantile navy was recruited solely from our orphan asylums, which we know is not the case.
But hang it all! You wouldn't have us absolutely merciless!
Yeah.
There's my difficulty. Until 12 o'clock I would. After 12 I wouldn't. Was ever a man placed in so delicate a situation?
And Ruth, your own Ruth, whom you love so well, and who's wandered middle-aged way into your boyish heart, what is to become of her?
Oh! He will take you with him!
Well, Ruth, I feel some little difficulty about you. It is true that I admire you very much, but I have been constantly at sea since I was 8 years old, and yours is the only woman's face I have seen during that time. I think it is a sweet face.
It is. Oh, it is.
I say I think it is. That is my impression. But as I've never had the opportunity of comparing you with other women, it is just possible I may be mistaken.
True.
What a terrible thing it would be if I were to marry this innocent person and then find out that she is, on the whole, plain.
Plain?
No.
What? Ruth?
Ruth. Ruth is very... Well, yes, very well indeed.
Yes, there are the remains of a fine woman about Ruth.
Do you really think so?
Oh, I do.
Well, then I shall not be so selfish as to take her from you. In justice to her, and in consideration for you, I will leave her behind.
No. Brethren, this cannot be. We are rough men. We lead a rough life. We are not so utterly heartless as to deprive thee of thy love. In fact, I think I am right in saying that there is not one here who would rob thee of this inestimable treasure for all the world holds dear.
Not one.
Thought there wasn't. Keep thy love, Frederick. Keep thy love.
You are very good, I'm sure.
Well, it's the top of the tide, and we must be off. Farewell, Frederick. And when your process of extermination begins, please let our deaths be as swift and painless as you can conveniently make them.
I will. By the love I have for you, I swear it. Could that you render this extermination unnecessary by accompanying me back to civilization?
No, Frederick, it cannot be. Though I do not think much of our profession, but contrasted with respectability, it is comparatively honest. No, Frederick, I shall live and die a pirate king! Sanctimonious parts with a pirate head and a pirate heart. Away to the cheating world go you, where pirates all are well to do. But I'll be true to the song I sing and live and die a pirate.
pirate king. And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king. I am the pirate king. It is a glorious thing to be a pirate king.
It is enough, the pirate king, enough, the pirate king.
When I sallied forth to seek my prey, I helped myself in a royal way. I sink a few more ships, it's true, than a well-bred monarch ought to do. If he wants to call his crown his own, must manage somehow to get through more dirty work than e'er I do. For I am the pirate king. It is a glorious thing to be a pirate king, but I am the pirate king.
I am the pirate king.
And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king.
It is for not the pirate king, for not the pirate king.
Considerably older than I, and a lad of 21 usually looks for a wife of 17.
A wife of 17? You will find me a wife of 1,000.
No, but I shall find you a wife of 47, and that is quite enough. Ruth, tell me candidly and without reserve, compared with other women, how are you?
I shall answer you truthfully, Master. I have a slight cold, but otherwise I'm quite well.
I am sorry for your cold, but I was referring rather to your personal appearance. Compared with other women, are you beautiful?
I've been told so, dear Master.
Ah, but lately?
Oh no, years and years ago.
Well, what do you think of yourself?
It is a delicate question to answer. But I think I am a fine woman.
And that is your candid opinion?
I should be deceiving you if I told you otherwise.
Thank you, Ruth. I believe you, for I'm sure you would not practice on my inexperience. I wish to do the right thing. And if, I say if you really are a fine woman, your age shall be of no obstacle to our union. To approach our all but inaccessible air.
Confusion, it is the voices of young girls. If you should see this, I am lost.
By all that is marvelous, a bevy of beautiful maidens.
Lost, lost, lost.
How lovely, how surpassingly lovely is the plainest of them. What grace, what delicacy, what refinement. And Ruth, told me she was beautiful.
Oh, false one, you have deceived me.
I have deceived you.
Yes, deceived me. You told me you were fair as gold.
And master, am I not so?
And now I see your plain and old.
I'm sure I'm not a chotso.
Upon my name, I'll sense you pain.
I'm not a wonder.
what shall I do? Before these gentle maidens, I dare not show in this alarming costume. No, no, I must remain in close concealment until I can appear in decent clothing.
Except for mermaids.
are quite alone. And the sea is as smooth as glass. Suppose we take off our shoes and stockings and paddle.
His beauty. How beautiful his tale. Thank you. beautiful thing. The sky, the glass is rising very high. Till you find, I hope it may, and yet it rained but yesterday. Till you find, I hope it may, and yet it rained but yesterday.
Animal and mineral.
I am the very model of a modern painted general. In fact, when I know what is meant by Mamelon and Ravelin, when I can tell at sight a Mauser rifle from a javelin, when such affairs as sorties and surprises I'm more wary at, and when I know precisely what is meant by commissariat, when I have learned when progress has been made in modern gunnery, when I know more of tactics than a novice in a nannery, in short, when I've a smattering of elemental strategy. Right. They'll say a better major general has never sat in the of my old age and leave me to go through the remainder of my life unfriended, unprotected, and alone. Well, yes, that's the idea. Tell me, have you ever known what it is to be an orphan?
Oh, come on, do it all again!
I ask you, have you ever known what it is to be an orphan? Often. Yes, often. Have you ever known what it is to be one? I say, often.
Often, often, often.
I don't think we quite understand one another. I ask you, have you ever known what it is to be an orphan? And you say often. As I understand you, you are merely repeating the word often to show that you understand me.
I did not repeat the word often.
Pardon me. Indeed.
I only repeated it once.
True, but you repeated it.
But not often!
Stop! I think I can see where we are getting confused. When you said orphan, did you mean orphan a person who has lost his parents, or orphan frequently?
I beg your pardon.
I see what you mean. Often, frequently.
Ah, oh, you said often, frequently.
No, only once! Exactly! You said often, frequently, only once!
Dismal fate, forgot your cruel employ. Have pity on my lonely state. I am an orphan boy,
an orphan boy,
an orphan boy.
I shall be indeed alone.
Poor fellow.
If pity you can feel, leave me my soul. Remain joy. See at your feet they kneel. Your heart you cannot steal. I can't the sad, sad tale.
it is a useful thing to be an orphan boy.
It is a so lovely orphan boy, a lovely orphan boy.
Come and dream of joy and sleep.
We will away a merry be. Oh, happy day with joy and sleep. We will away a merry be.
Should we fall asleep, the sweet, the sisters, all the bridesmaids be.
Thank you.